Hi everyone, what's up? Do you like to play a video game? What is your favorite game? I'm asking this because this video clip was made for the video game collaboration which organized by Anastasia Custom. And the participant artist as shown on the screen. After watching this video, you can watch other artist clip on the links in the description box below. I'm normally not a game enthusiast, so that is difficult to me to choosing a character to do. But currently, I really like to make a fun doll, so I choose Lightfork Draenei from World of Warcraft Alliance. We can customize character in the game, and also I really love the gold stamp on her back very much. Okay, let's start. In this video, I choose the Frost DC superhero girl dolls. I remove her dress and accessory, cut the hair, remove the makeup with 100% pure acetone, but I will keep her lips color. Then I make a wig. Firstly, make a wig cap and then attach the alpaca hairs, layers by layer until full of the head. Leave the center part and pierce the wig. Then I insert the hair weave and glue inside of the wig. After that, I can cut and style as the referent. I use polymer clay because the weight is lighter than epoxy sculpt. By sculpting polymer clay into the worm shape first, then cut and bend follow the sketching. Use the Fimo liquid to connect them together. After that, bake in the oven at specified temperature that described on the packaging for 15 minutes. Then sand at the back to make it flat for attach the magnet and decorate with a triangle shaped polymer clay. Stack 3 layers and bake again. After that, we can paint as we want. The Draenei has tentacle beside the ear. How to make the tentacle? I just roll stretch fabric and secure with fabric glue. As you can see, I really enjoy doing this, so I make a lot. When the glue completely dry, then poke a hole on the side of the ear and insert 2 tentacles for each side. You may use super glue to fix them, but I don't use because it's tight enough. I pierce the hole and insert the wire on the top of the ear and bend the wire like the ear shape. After that, use the epoxy sculpt to sculpt the upper part of the ear to make a pointy ear like an elf. We move on to the legs modification. I measure the length and then cut at the back of the calf, but not truly, just leave a little bit at the front part. And the male done this job very well, more easily and quickly for me. Once I finish this cut, I push the lower leg to the front and then use a boxy sculpt to mold the shape as I want. After the first attempt, I feel dislike the shape of the leg, so I scrape some of the calf out and I really scared that I could make it broken at this moment. But finally, I got the shape as I want. For the hoof part, I cut the paper into the hoof shape pattern first, and then add epoxy sculpt until I got the shape as the pattern. After that, smooth it with sandpaper. For the pant, I cannot find the right color fabric as I want at first, so I use white stretch fabric. I start by making the pattern first, then cut the fabric and sew. But finally, I can fly the fabric as I want. So I have to make another one. Then make a front skirt part and attach a ribbon, then paint with a gold acrylic color on the edge. At the back of her pant, it's light armor, so I paint the backs with silver acrylic color. But because of the fabric is stretchy, so I mix the textile medium into the color for helping the acrylic color it can be flexible and not easily broken. For the tail, I use the same tentacle making method. But I put a wire inside before I roll the stretch fabric, so the tail will be possible. Then make a hole at the coccyx area with rimel and stick the tail with epoxy glue. After the leg was done, I still have time before deadline, so I change my plan to go with the armor. At first, I plan to make the whole armor set with polymer clay, but I realized that I had made a wood fairy doll in November 2016. And her dress made from Mobla. Both breastplate, skirt, and even her shoes were made from Mobla. And I still have enough Mobla for making two dolls. Don't wait, let's make some more. For the breastplate, I cut Mobla into a size that can cover the doll's head. But don't forget to wrap the doll with a cloth to protect the glue from wobblers that can be stick to the doll. Then use heat air gun, blow until the wobbler is softened. You may use a molding tool to help for shaping. And let wobbler cool down and draw the desired shape with permanent marker. Then use a scissor to cut as drawn. I'm quite obsessed with remove above accessory, so I make a hole and sew a few leather strap at both of the end of the breastplate. Don't throw away the leftover wobbler. We can cut into a small squares and thin line to decorate along the edge for creating 3D looks. For the bigger pieces that need more attention, such as shoulder plate, tusses, or greaves, I will make the pattern first and draw on the wobbler, then cut along the line and form the shape as the reference. And decorate with stripped wobbler at the edge. For the shoulder plate, after blowing hot air to form the shape, then I drill a hole to insert an elastic string loop. We will wear this loop under the armpit, after that, attach arm to pass to it. Another advantage of wobbler is that we can use the things to be the model as we want. Like this one, I mold the wobbler on the rivet to be used for decoration. Once all parts are finished, then the painting process. I use wood glue as the primer, paint the glue two layers and let each layer dry completely. This will help to smooth the surface and help the color stick well. For the breastplate strap, I sew a small bead at one end and the other side I cut a hole to make a buttonhole like this. Then make a sock from the same pants fabric. I use a wood skewer with wooden beads, plug them together and mold them with polymer clay. Then bake in the oven and paint with acrylic color. Come back to the leg. Usually I should use an airbrush, but at this time I'm bored with an airbrush cleaning and I have to move to other place. That is inconvenient for me, so I change my plan by painting with a paintbrush instead. Then blotching and protecting the surface with MSC. Don't forget the gold stamp tattoo on her back. I paint with golden acrylic color, then attach rhinestone at the base of the tail. And also don't forget to wear a ring on the tail as well. And paint the hoof. I will switch her hand with a leather dots for she can holding the stuff. I will save the time by using the original lips color. After spraying with MSC 2-3 times, I start repaint by making eyebrow stencil. If you wanna know how to do this, let's check the links below. The Draenei has the glowing pupilless eye, but I quite don't like it much. So I put the pupil with smoky eyes and a little lashes to her. Paint the white spot with acrylic color and we're done! Alright guys, what do you think? Do you like her? After watching this video, don't forget to check another links video. If you have any ideas for the next arm model, you can leave a comment below. For today, bye!